Good evening. How's it going? Please tell me you can all hear me. For crying out loud, has Lewis been banned, has he? That's not acceptable, is it? I've got to sort Nightbot out there, because he shouldn't be getting banned. Should not be getting banned. Oh no, he just got all his message deleted. Lewis deserved it. Oh my goodness. Poor Lewis getting wrecked. Okay. Well, hello everyone. That's quite the turnout, hey? For everybody in here. Oh no. good. I'll be honest, I was like walking around getting ready to start the stream, and I glanced over and saw saw the scapegoat message. Oh, Atom, that's you doing that. Oh, goodness me. Goodness me, poor Lewis. Poor Lewis, he's getting absolutely wrecked in Smok's chat. He'll never come back. Anyway, how are we all doing? What more in your band? We're having modern warfare. Oh, get it? Oh, that's terrible. That's absolutely terrible. Well, I hope everyone's doing all good. Now, I'm trying something with this camera, right? Better turn it on. Okay, it's pretty dark. But I'm hoping... I don't want to have to turn my big overhead light on. Because it's not very pleasant. BRB, writing a whole paragraph to defend myself while everyone is and will still be against me. Oh. Oh, that's fantastic, that is. That's terrible. Oh, that's beautiful. That's definitely scapegoat behavior. Okay, I do hope that camera's alright. I know it's dark, but I don't want to have to turn my big overhead light on. So, we'll run with that. I mean, you can still see what I'm doing anyway, so... We're not forgetting that in a hurry. No, we are not. Don't forget to bring up a particular someone for some reason. Atom writing Lamau be like, that's, yeah, look, to be fair, that's me as well, sometimes. Not all the time. Not all the time, but sometimes you gotta type Lamau with a straight face. But then other times, oh dear. Okay. Yeah, but other times I simply cannot do enough to convey how much I'm laughing. But, okay. Agenda for tonight. I actually cracked a smile, have you know? Oh, yeah, good. Look out for the next Trackside Lounge podcast, Smock Forehead Reveal. That's it, isn't it? Yes, so for everyone watching, Atom and Nismo and I all recorded an episode of the Trackside Lounge today. So I'm hoping to get that out before Christmas. It's actually going to be a few days before Christmas because I'm going out of town for Christmas. So I need to get that episode done. I'm going to try maybe do it Sunday. I think that's the plan. Get a couple of my own videos done tomorrow and then get that podcast done on Sunday. Don't remind me, I'm dreading it. Atom for the big win at RBHQ. Oh, I'll see you on Saturday, remember, Atom? Nice. You can sort it out like men. What's the topic? It's actually, I don't know whether to say. Don't know whether to say or keep it a surprise. Let me put it this way, we had more to talk about. We had more to talk about, but we simply spent too long on some of the earlier stuff, so we decided to make what we recorded today its own episode, which will be the one I get out. And then in the new year we're going to record the second part two, if you will. But it'll be a separate thing. But yeah, that I'll keep the rest a surprise. We get distracted and go off on tangents a lot. We do, yes. It's very much run like a conversation rather than like we ask a question and we stick to a strict topic, which I think is fine. I prefer it that way. But yeah, okay. Tez, are you coming? Or what, you can't? Oh, Tez, mate, yeah, I heard about this Red Bull HQ thing. But anyway, we're gonna get started. Alright, agenda for tonight, 25th anniversary for Gran Turismo. So, happy anniversary, I guess. But, we've essentially just got these two races, which is... This is the 25th anniversary stuff. Are these two races? So basically, the two events, two offline events that basically replicate what they saw for the Manufacturer Series and Nations Cup combination at Monaco, and we're going to be having a go at it. I've been non-stop working since Saturday. I've been non-stop working. Once Saturday comes, I'm either working again or I need a well-earned break. That's fair, Tez. I can understand that. The Trackside podcasts are good, like, that it's just a conversation. More entertaining and actually keeps me interested and not skipping the whole time. That's what I like to hear. I had a feeling that may have been the case, so, I'm glad that certainly is the case. Okay, well, I guess you guys can pick the car for me. Well, what do we want? What do we want to see? That, I tell you what, that McLaren livery, that there is beautiful. Oh, I really like that McLaren livery there. But I'm not saying I want to drive the car. I'll let, who wants to pick? Lexus. Lexus is the current calling. Where is it? There it is. First one. Can't couldn't be that far. Nismo says the Honda. Atom's absolutely grilling him here. Absolutely grilling Tez. Poor Tez. Getting roasted. Honda. Yeah, Nismo's been thinking a lot about the Honda today. So it's between the Lexus or the Honda. Does someone else want to chime in and give me the tiebreaker? we all broke. Let me know when you're out east next, dude, or grab some lunch with you. Aw, look at that, that's cute. Could go have a cheeky lunch date. Aren't you moving out or something, Tez? Oh, are you? Can somebody please tie break the Lexus and Honda? It's down to those two. Oh, Lewis comes in with a third option. The Beetle. The Beetle. The Beetle. Lexus, Honda, or Beetle? For crying out loud, I don't know how to pick. BMW, for crying out loud. I've gotten four different cars and I've got four viewers at the moment, so obviously gotta be Yogurt's BMW. I can't handle this. Where's your automatic decision maker website? Do I go BMW for the memes? Oh, come on. Surely. Oh dear. I like a good BMW, to be fair, so I might actually go the BMW. Wayne Greening. Hey, I haven't seen you for ages. Same here, Wayne. How have you been? Thank you for jumping in. I'll go Merc and drive like they do. If by they you mean, the Formula One team. That's okay. We'll go BMW. We'll activate. Never mind. So, is there a BMW here? No. Okay, I don't think the BMW is particularly good, but that's okay. Well, let's go. They're not going to do themselves. I'll tell you what. I've been hearing a glitch going around where the engine sound just doesn't play. And I got that glitch when I was making the thumbnail for this stream. Yeah, good brother. Hot on the Gold Coast. Yeah, it's well, I'm not on the Gold Coast, but I'm in the same region. So yeah, it was a warm one today. Did you attend the Supercars round over the Gold Coast a couple of months ago? Oh, that's a bit wide. Okay, this got to be one of those ones where it absolutely buckets down rain right at the end. Because I heard the weather for this is random. Okay, so you can't actually take that flat, apparently. Don't know what that penalty was for, but okay. Watch out for a Lambo. Don't send him into an apex with a lag bump. He might get you back. Oof. You did go, Wayne. That's good. Whoa! Oh, look at my tire wear. Goodness me. Okay. Might have to reevaluate this. Might have to reevaluate. Oh, all good, Wayne. Have a good shift, mate. On that night shift. Tough. That is tough, but that's okay. That Subaru has a lot of grip. Okay. Well, how long will this one take? About 25 minutes or something? 30 minutes? 10 laps. And it'll be a 2 minute. What, 18 lap time? Something like that. Past the Porsche, lovely. Oh, there's some rain coming, so... Alright, this will be interesting with this turbocharged BMW. Oh. Slightly misjudged that. But we'll pretend that didn't happen. I wonder if they'll give everyone a free G923. That'd be alright if you could all get one of those. Nearly ran straight up the back end of the McLaren there. I was saying to... Yeah, that's a fair penalty. I was saying to Asim and Nismo today, this event sounds really cool. I would totally attend if I could and was not in a different country. Funny how being in a different country, that'll do it, won't it? Yeah, gotta chuck the cool in there. Rain inbound, yeah, I can't wait for it to absolutely bucket down rain. Gotta chuck it down. My rule of thumb with this situation, but I know there's heavy rain on the way, never start a lap. Okay, so you can spin out on the curb on the inside. My rule of thumb in this situation is never start a lap if it's raining. If it's not raining though, like if it's actively not raining, then you can go past. So it looks like I'll do one more lap here. looks. Some parts of it look heavy, but then other parts don't really. Depends, because it's like a getting in there with the cool Tez. Too cool for school. I exaggerated it there, by the way. This car's a handful, I think. It's gonna start raining in a minute. Get those wipers on. I guess we're gonna box this lap. What do we reckon? Inters or wets? I'll zoom out that radar. Inters or wets, do we reckon? I don't know. Inters or wets? I'm gonna go inters. That's the final decision. Inters, I think. Because it looks like it was just a band. Oh. I pressed do not refuel like an absolute tool. Okay, well, hopefully this rain only lasts 3 laps then. Goodness me. Okay, I think I've bottled the strategy, but we'll see how we go, actually, because this is going to be into conditions, like, it's into conditions now and everyone stayed out. I'm gonna concentrate now. I cannot look at chat, unfortunately. Otherwise that happens. Oh dear. It's okay, we'll keep going. Alright, I'm in aquaplane conditions now for the inters. But it looks like the rain shouldn't last long. Thank you.
think there's still people out on slicks. Here's one. Hairy for a moment. We're back into intermediate territory. Hopefully that rain is going to stop shortly. Oh shit, it's wet. Yeah, it's a bit wet, eh? I'm not a meteorologist, but it seems a bit wet. I like the puddles. The puddles look fantastic. That's something we didn't see in the, exhibition season that just went. Never was wet enough to show the puddles. They look really good. Need it to stop raining and then I'll be right on the inters. Very good, we got through it. We should be okay on the inters now. My fuel, I gotta worry about fuel. I think I'd have to box again, I think. Actually, it's gonna get ready for dries. Look how dry the track is all of a sudden. I binned it. I binned it, unfortunately. Yeah, that was not my finest move. Yeah, I died. I died, unfortunately. But look how dry that's gotten all of a sudden. I'm gonna pit for slicks at the end of this lap. I'll check the weather radar and make sure there's no more rain coming. Doesn't look like it. Alright, do we reckon slicks? I reckon slicks. It's like, it's a bit wet here. I mean, the water meter is just above that 1/3. But I reckon in most spots it's dry enough. By the time we get there on the next lap, it'll probably be pretty dry. See what everyone else does. They're all staying out. Mega undercut time, I reckon. We gotta do 4 laps. I reckon the mediums. Yeah, and gotta refuel. Gotta refuel. Nah, not yet. Still pissed down again. Well, I needed fuel anyway, so. Did I accidentally? Oh my goodness. I got a pit. I absolutely bottled that. Whoa. I ballsed up the fuel. This isn't going well, is it? I don't believe I just did that. I think, you know what I did? I know exactly what I did. I pressed the wiper button to turn off the wipers. Because I was in the pit stop, it was the select button for the refuel. Seek water. Bloody idiot. That's okay. Seek water. I think fuel is the fluid I need to seek. Yeah, I got to come in the pits again. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Might as well chuck a fresh set of tires. Okay, don't touch the refuel now. I don't think I'm gonna win this now. Shall I restart? Okay, let's see what we can do. All I can hope for is that everyone up ahead is on the wet pits in, and that I don't crash. That's all I can hope for at this point. nearly got pulled off at Puon. Oh, there's someone pitting. Damn it! They're still ages ahead, aren't they? You reckon it's worth restarting? I'm not gonna gain 20 seconds in 2 laps. Can't get held up. That's the other thing that can't happen. There we go. That was a nice little move. Frustrating. Bit of a frustrating little race, this one. To be fair, right? I gained 7 seconds in that lap. But not the, the 10 I needed. That second pit stop ruined it. Or the third, I guess the third. No, well, I really ruined it on the second one when I pressed do not refuel. What do we reckon, gentlemen? Restart? Wow.
I'm gonna have to restart, unfortunately. What a shame. At least I know what the weather's gonna do. Ah, dear. Goodness me. This BMW is quite difficult to drive, actually. It's a bulky car and it kind of oversteers weirdly. Almost like the weather transition in this race. It's like so quick you don't have time to adapt to the new conditions, but by the time you're all warmed up for the weather conditions, it's already dry. Which is certainly an interesting dynamic. Catch you off guard by braking there, I tell ya. Alright, there's that rain again. Actually, I'll go the wets this time because I know the rain doesn't last very long. That's that weird oversteer. Oh, that felt nice. That felt very nice. Slipstream Mr. Gallo for a bit. I guess we go around for one more time.
Though, what kind of weather did, or everyone that's done this one, what kind of weather did you guys get? So I've heard it's different at random. You may or may not get rain at all. Suddenly it starts to get a bit foggy, a bit cloudy. Guess we're boxing this lap. We've had a much better opening stint, actually. Just had a couple of pretty fast laps there. We'll go full wet this time. I won't do my fuel yet. I'll do my fuel in the next stop. Okay, good opening stint. Good opening stint. Let's not bottle the pit stops now. Everyone's gonna slide off here, you watch. Because look at that moisture meter, it's just gone above 1/3. Yep. Oh, Porsche in the barrier. First time we've seen that at Spa in the wet in the recent past. I'll read that in a second, Nismo. Man, it's so wet. Look at them all here. Okay, if I don't win this one, there's something wrong with me. can't even get into the pit lane. The only way these races could be more like Monaco is if you have a 1 in 12 chance of having rig 4, which means you erase black screens randomly at any time through the race. your handbrake plays up. Oh my goodness, I've got to get rid of that Nightbot. I really do. Sorry, GTR, I did see it was you. I've got to get rid of that Nightbot, that's ridiculous. That message gets removed. How you going, GDR? How are you, TX3? You were on my Twitch Wrapped. I think you were my... were you my fourth most viewed channel? I surely gotta do one for YouTube these days. Instead we get YouTube Rewind. Aren't they terrible? Still no face revealed. Do you even have a face? That is the real question, isn't it? How you going, Foss? Lovely to see you in here. Yeah, no, 500 subs, that's the target. No, it's funny, actually. We were recording a Trackside Lounge episode today, and we were recording at sunset for me. So the sun, like, coming through my windows, even though I had them blacked out, let enough light in so that you could just about start to make out some features of mine. But it's okay. Shows how much Twitch you watch because I've barely streamed this year. Yeah, that's fair. I'm not on Twitch daily, I'm hardly on Twitch weekly. What a Shrek is. Oh, the little, the stalks with the circles on it. How's that for a description of Shrek? Alright, I think we're boxing this lap for slicks. And we gotta put fuel in the car. Don't let me forget to put fuel in the car. If you're just joining now, I bottled the last iteration of this race. Because I accidentally pressed do not refuel. Still haven't done this race. Yeah, well, this is my first time doing it as well. This is the first time for everything. But they've got 20 days left, GTR, and they pay out 1 million credits each. It is definitely worth doing. So I'm going to do this in the Escudo race tonight, and then hopefully we can go over to some Road Atlanta. Not sure if Nismo is still here. But he really wants to see me have a go at Road Atlanta because I've never driven it before, so that would be good to see. Okay. If I recall correctly, all of these cars still have a pit stop to do. Because they're still on the wet tyres. Because they made a large error by pitting one lap too late for the wets. They lost so much time. The one is easy because it's only 7 minutes. Oh, okay, right. 1 million credits in 7 minutes. That's good. That sounds like a nice clickbait thumbnail. Just wait for Kirith to, or have already done it. Poor Kirith, I really shouldn't say that. Sure, Kirith is a great bloke. A large error. Large error. Sounds like your mate, GTR. Do elaborate. What's he done? What has he done? Actually, I'll tell you what's fallen off, to be fair, right? His esports team. I hear nothing about that anymore. Shame, really, because I'm sure he invested quite a bit of time into getting it sorted and stuff, but it just seems like it never took off, really. Esports team won. Yeah, fair enough. I should join. See if I can revive it. It's not a shame. I just feel bad for the bloke. Well, not even the bloke. I would feel bad for anybody if they put so much effort in. I guess I don't really know how much effort he put in. Ah, well, what can you do? Another clickbait tactic that failed. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, definitely tracks a lot of hate, to be honest. Like on Twitter, there's always He's always quiet. He cops a bit of flack in his replies, and then... But he does clickbait a lot, and... it's not good. See, my take on clickbait, right? See, if someone has, like, a title, but it's a question, then, that's fair. Or a title that can potentially be taken as clickbait, but then if you actually watch the video, it works itself out. Like, I would say my recent video, the Monaco demo, for those that don't know what the Monaco demo is, they probably see Monaco and assume... They see Monaco in the title and assume that I'm racing at Monaco. But it's like, it would only classify as clickbait if people have no idea what the Monaco demo is. That being said, though, I don't believe it's a clickbait title. I want to read that. He posted a video and labeled it how to get a top 10 lap time in the world or something along those lines, but all he did was do a lap in the first 5 minutes of a daily race and claimed it. Oh. Right. Well. Okay. That, if you ask me, GTR, that sounds like clickbait. Because he totally would do so. Okay. Yeah, that is something he would do, isn't it? Yeah, I can't respect that, unfortunately. See, I think some people look down unfavorably upon... This is not, actually, to be fair, this isn't really related to Kirith, but it's kind of a tangent. People that upload their top 10 laps, I know GTR, you do this. I think there are some people that look down on that a bit, because they're like, oh, showing off. But it's like, no, showing you something I'm proud of, because I've done it. Or I think my top 10 laps, I've uploaded them. Yeah, it's such a curious thing to do, yeah, I know. He's the Arava of the GT community. Oh, no, I'm not up to speed on the old F1 side of things. So I watch TM at Marduk occasionally, but that's it. What does old Arava get up to? Just clickbait stuff like that. Yeah, Tim at Marduk is a good bloke. Met him at the GP in 2017. Yeah, he sounds like a top bloke. I have a funny, not really a story, but something funny I did on one of his Instagram posts. He was on, he obviously grinds out his career mode, which full respect to that, by the way. I think that's a pretty good series. That's actually the only Formula One game series that I watch, his career mode. But yeah, he was pumping that out, and then he went on holidays or something to some Mediterranean location. It might have been Greece, actually. And he just made an Instagram post on the boat, and then I went in his replies, and I just said post career mode, and I got the top comment. I'm a bit jelly of him, to be honest, because he's, like, been to Monaco several times for the race. I can only dream of being rich enough one day to be able to go to Monaco just once. It's on the bucket list, though. I used to watch all this career mode stuff back when I played F1. How hard did you get into the F1 stuff? I'm sure you've spoken about it before, but I don't think, personally, I haven't heard too much about it. Were you an esports level driver? Get in there, Lewis. Fantastic drive, mate. Miracles do happen, mate. He is partnered with Veloce and McLaren, so it doesn't surprise me. Fair enough. Yeah, he probably gets those trips paid, to be fair. Okay, excellent. Are we any good on this? What did we get then? There. 25:14. Wow, look at this. 22s. 3 minutes faster. That's crazy. Keen to see you lap Atlanta and see what you reckon. I tell you what, Nismo. I'm going to do this, just going to do this other race here. This one. But, what is it? Seven laps, so... Oh, leaderboards are pretty irrelevant due to randomised weather. Ah, that's a good point. Thank you. Okay. That did not click in my mind. Back then, I only did career mode and had enough of the online to get trophies. I was slow because I was on a controller back then. Ah, okay. Fell off them when I got into GT Sport more seriously. Ah, fair enough. They won't have had any rain. Yes, that's fair. I'll just do this race quick. It should only take about 10 minutes, because it's only a 7 lapper, and this lap is about a minute. Just over a minute, if I recall correctly. Okay, don't touch the brake. Scotty, how you going, mate? You can get lucky and do the Spa race without having to go on the Wets or Inters. Yeah, fair enough. That'd be how those people got their quick times. Okay, let's get through this race. It's only 7 laps. Okay, here's something that... Whoops. Something that blows my mind, right? This is a real car. I know pretty much everyone knows that, and I did know that, but it's like... It's such a ridiculous feeling car. But it's just crazy to think it's actually real. I wonder where they are now. They'd probably be worth a fortune, I reckon. I wonder where they are now. They're probably packed in a museum. Or I say they, maybe it's a one-off. Maybe there's only one maid. Whoa! Run and lift it up off the ground there. Alright, I don't want to get dirty air and fly off the track here. Hard to look away to see chat with this one. Caught up to Adriano Crash Ratzer. Make sure we don't fly off at this final corner, eh? Have you got Need for Speed Unbound? I haven't, no. It's not my kind of game. That being said, though, I've been watching... Well, obviously, I've been watching Super GT's videos on them. On it. And they look... quite amusing, but I feel like it's the same kind of racing you get in Forza Horizon 5, which I already have, so I don't really have an additional itch that Need for Speed could scratch, if that makes sense. So I'll save myself the money. I'm not a fan of the animations. Some of them are alright, but like when the car like glitches, so you like hit something, that's pretty cringe, I have to say. But I am also aware that the it's not like built for Forza is garbage. Hey, I don't mind it. I don't mind Forza Horizon. See a message earlier about his car. See if I can. What is it? It's a real car, but in real life, it has a 60% chance to explode at any given time. Oh dear, yeah. What else? You know this thing's twin engine, right? Oh yeah, I think I did. To be fair. I looked up its Wikipedia article the other day because I was like, oh, is this like
was that an actual real car? And it turns out it is. I thought you were a man of culture. Hey, I've streamed it a couple of times before.
I was about to say, the next sentence that was about to come out of my mouth was they should make a Forza Horizon based in Australia, but they legit have. Number three, I think. You can, like, drive around Surfers Paradise, Byron Bay. Get in there, Lewis. Fantastic drive, mate. I'll never forget the Aussie newsreaders doing a story on boy races. It was Forza Horizon 3 footage. Forza and Grid is the reason we can't get another V8 Supercars game. That is disappointing. I'll agree with that. Sounds like an Australian thing to do. You would know, wouldn't you, GTR? Alright, excellent. Alright, let's see how far off I was on that one. 7:41. Okay, so I'm like 20 seconds off. Wow, 7:20. Man, these people just must be absolutely nailing this. What's that, 7 laps and they're 20 seconds faster than me? That's over 2 seconds a lap. So would you, you Queenslander. I know, absolute Queenslander dog. Okay, well, look at that. 11.4 million. I finally reached my savings goal, so I can buy the McLaren MP44 next time it rocks up. I know it's not in here, but I'm just checking. Checking if there's anything. Oh, yeah, there's a couple I don't have. Oh, well. Okay. Whoops. Road Atlanta, then. So, what do you recommend, Nismo? Should I do the circuit experience, maybe? Would that be a good thing to do? Or will I go, like, go into World Circuits and... do like one of these. Probably a wise move, or one of the lower class races. Okay, wonder what cars. Go full send, 30 minutes, group one. What's the suggested PP? 550. Should I do this one? American FR Challenge? How good's the Christmas music? Let's give this a go. Let's try this Corvette. Oh, it's only 3 laps. We'll do this one, and we may as well do all of them. See, what are the other, the turbo one? That'll be what? 5 laps? We may as well do all three. Straight off the track. Did you say I'd do that this way? This looks like a hard traction zone. So it's like up over a crest. Do the circuit experience. Here's the thing, Nismo. I can, and I probably will. But as for the other circuit experience, like the other tracks, I haven't done them yet. Because I want it to be stream content, but I just don't stream that often. Oh, actually. Gonna use the H pattern for this. Don't really. Oh dear. Tell you what, technical little first section in this car. How's that interior? See, that corner lures you to take it wide, but it doesn't. Get back on the paddles because I'm not. Oh man, that's hard to sight. Okay, so in this lower class of car, that whole first section is so technical in a car like this.
I'm not going to win that race. I might go and do the circuit experience. I think that'll be a good place to start. Or... No, you know what? I'm going to save the circuit experience for the stream that I want to do. I'm going to do this, It's not all that much easier in a race car, right. Let's find out. Take on your 950 PP class. Okay. There we go. Porsche 919 hybrid. Easy peasy. Oh. It's actually got to be less. What tyres have I got on that? Oh. Alright, let's do this. It's 2019 OP here. Yeah, true, it would be too. Let's try this one. Okay. Just straight up crash at turn one. Alright, what's turn one like then? Is it like a lift? Wow. Braking points. I have to suss out braking points. The hard part. Let's try coming into here. This sign. Okay, maybe just after the sign. Is turn one flat in this car? Go flat, but it costs high life. Okay, that makes sense. Let's try just after this side. I just thought I'd try the 360 line. Wow. That turn one is fast.
Oh, how's that? Hybrid generates from turn one. It's like all the other American tracks where it can't rain. I'll tell you what. I'm starting to get the hang of it, and it feels very nice. Carry more speed through that corner. Alright, this combination feels very nice actually. You'd think a Group 1 car is too fast for this track, but it feels really good. I have to say, I'm quite enjoying this. I'm gonna have to pit this lap though. Oh my goodness, I heard the pit entry is dodgy. Oh my god, oh my god. Don't reset me. Okay, that pit entry is no laughing matter, is it? Oh, it finishes at night too. Oh, okay. Oh, that's beautiful. We gotta suss out that pit entry. I really should have put the 4K headlights in there. You did what I did. Did you do the exact same thing? Oh, it's one of the ones where you watch the car drive out of the pit lane. Oh my goodness. A bit late on the brakes. I'm still trying to figure out braking points. I think I've got it. Just on the apex of this curve. Just on the white line. And then just as you meet the outside curve. Except I turn around and got reset. Oh, what a classic. I'm glad I'm not the only one struggling in entry. Start recharging.
Whoa!
There's alternate layouts here, isn't there? Okay, well I did a boo-boo. That's how you know you're pushing. That's a tight corner. It's tighter than it looks. Oh, what the hell? What the heck? I like that little resurface part there. That'd be where, like, cars were bottoming out. Ooh, that's a hard corner. Oh my goodness. That's such a hard corner. What's that? Is that turn two? Three? Oh, got a penalty. Yeah, that turn, I think it's turn three. That's hard because you're like looking on the left for the curb, but then the apex is over on the right. Bit better, it was slow though. How was that for a move? Gonna try and save some hybrid. I'm a bit low. up here. I'm not gonna be up anymore. Oh no, poor Twitchy's in last. Poor Twitchy in P20. Rest in peace, Twitchy. Halfway in the race. This lap, I think. Well, that was a waste of time. Huh. What a difficult pit entry. Okay. I'm really enjoying this track, by the way. This is great. That's so satisfying to chuck this car around here. Whoops. That'll be to cross the lines, won't it? You need to brake for that corner. Yes, thanks, Nismo. Okay, let's head back in the game. You love the TT then, yeah. I'll give that a go next, I think. Win this race. If I don't win this race on this occasion, I'll try again. I'll try and save a bit of fuel on this stint. well. What am I doing? I can't drive now. Thrown off by the back marker there. Also notable is pit line penalties are only 1 second here. Okay. That's good. That. Imagine if you're 3 seconds cutting it. I wonder if that's actually PD showing us some mercy because they know it's so easy to cut. Alright, I have to get back in the program here. I'm not lapping quick enough. Beautiful, that's a bit of lap. Not really saving any fuel, but oh no! Silliness, absolute silliness. beautiful sunset now. Oh, Banana Josh, g'day. How you doing? Lovely to see you. As you can see, Road Atlanta. Whoops. 0.9 laps, brave. Yeah, thought why not. Change tyres. How much time? 3 minutes. So what's that going to be like? 4 laps? We'll go 5 just in case. Dude, fuel mix. Oh, it's alright. I really should have avoided this last pit stop. I should have saved my fuel a bit better across the race and I would have been able to avoid this one. But let's see what I can do. How far off am I? 15 seconds. Oh, okay, can't see now. I'm not gonna win this. Oh no, push it too hard. What do I do? Do I restart? Surely it's out of pits. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to cop the L for this. Nah, Hazel hasn't pitted, has he? What do I do here, fellas? Do I restart? Would you mind if I... take the money, at least. Fair enough, I am right here, so... ah, dear. I would have been fine if I'd driven a bit better. I mean, I was only... what was that, like, 8 seconds away? Or 7 seconds away? I'm able to do 104s, see, 104.9, but I was doing like 108 in some laps. What do we reckon? Shall I go one more time? Should I do it? Should I do that again? Because that's not very satisfying to me, sitting second behind an AI. Or will I go and do the time trial? Yeah, even fuel map 2 or 3 would add up. Yeah, I can definitely avoid that last pit stop. Should I give it another go? Yeah, try again, yeah. Let's go. Let's try and avoid that last pit stop. Let's go. I reckon I can do it without fuel maps. Oh, actually, no. I'll fuel map in a sec. When I get out onto a straight and I can adjust it. That's the best corner on the track, that fast left. seeing if I can eke out. See, it's 5.5. I'm seeing if I can eke out another half a lap. Better call it a night. Take care, smoke and chat. No worries, Nismo. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks for recording today for the Trackside Lounge. Look forward to getting that one done and dusted. But yeah, Road Atlanta's great. This is fantastic, especially in this car. That was a hairy moment. Hard to try and judge when to use the fuel mix because, like, you take your hand off the wheel, it's so sketchy. not know he was going the pit lane. This lap. That's what rules up the pit entry I have, haven't I? Gonna get a 1 second penalty for that pit entry. It's impossible to see where it like curves to the right. Impossible. Turn, sort out this fuel. I don't quite think I have enough just yet. And a pit entry's dangerous, hey! You can't see the lines, you can't see when other cars are going in. Good grief. Thank you. slept new faster slap. Much cleaner drive this time around. One thing about it is sector one was too narrow to overtake. Yeah, I can. They run the Petit Le Mans here, am I right? Am I correct in saying that? If they do run the Petit Le Mans here, where there's like hypercars and group and like GT3 cars, there must be some awkward moments that happens in turn one. best box this lap. What a difficult pit entry. I said that last time, didn't I? Man, there's quite a bit to do in this car. There's the fuel mapping and the hybrid. And then, like, it's hard trying to fuel map at the end of the straight and hybrid safe as well. That's right. Oh no! That's me to get shafted by back markers. That'll be a penalty. I'm sort of a bit wonky. Another one. Turned in too early that time. crying out loud, I think that's another one. I'm losing it. Losing the plot. Gee, that was dangerous to go for that gap. This is going to be a correct lap this time. Not mucking around anymore. Get everything right. Do that again. Just thinking, I think I've only got 2 laps left. Oh, I'm crying out loud. I feel like that penalty came up late. I knew that was the last lap, so I tried to push it. this will be the final lap. Here, it's happened again. I know, you just told me not to do it. Look what I bloody did. Oh, I've just used all my fuel. Excellent. We got there in the end. Oh dear. Tell you what, I'm getting bloody tired. Okay, well. I think what I'm gonna do. Is check out this time trial, because I want to get the 2 million. Obviously want to get the 2 million here, but yeah, so I suppose we'll use the 25th anniversary, hey? Good start. Okay, hopefully this doesn't take too long. This car's ridiculous, hey? How are people doing that flat? Alright, we've got a long way to go here. Okay. This thing is actually pretty slippery. Definitely not the time of night for me to be driving this sort of car, but we'll see what we can do. Man, I'm struggling with that corner. I really am. I'm not a big fan of driving Road Atlantic, the Red Bull X 2019. What time have you got? You managed a decent time. I can't do this corner. I saw Mr. MCA grinded this a bit. I saw Danny have a few goes. Oh my god. It's not one of those cars where it, normally when a car starts wheel spinning, it settles itself down. Eventually this car doesn't. I don't think this won't be gold, but it'll be a decent improvement. One 1.2, okay. This car, 1:08, okay. Have you seen, I think the gold is 1:02 now. Like, it's almost like you need a 59 in order to be confirmed for gold. It's crazy. This is one of the most competitive time trials I've seen. I guess everyone's gravitated towards the X2019. It's the flagship Gran Turismo racer, so to speak. There we go, this will be an improvement. 1:06. Try and pick out an accurate breaking point for this. This is... Oh, Andrew, how you going? Still going, yes, yes. I've only just started this in the last 20 minutes or so, to be fair. Going deep there. Yeah, not too bad, thanks, Andrew. We recorded a Trackside Lounge episode today, so I'm going to try and get that out sometime in the next week or so. So that'll be good. But yeah, then I just decided to jump on and stream. We'll just pretend like that didn't happen. Yeah, we did the 25th anniversary races. Got a couple of million credits from that, and then we're just exploring what Road Atlanta's like. This is so difficult. How's your time trial campaign going, Andrew? I know you mentioned at the start of it you really want to be world record. Is that still the case? Thanks, Andrew. Yeah, it seems like I'm gonna need it. If I could get a 59, I'd be happy with that, but it seems pretty difficult. Gotta pick out a better breaking point for that. I gave on it after seeing the grass lines. Fair enough, okay. Don't tell me you need the grass to get gold. If I can get gold without using the grass, that'd be handy. Sector 1 is a joke. Yeah, look, fair enough. struggling with that corner. Turn three, I think it is. I'll get there though, I'll get there. There we go, game time in the last second. Oh, 2/10 in the last sector, yes please. Come on, I got a 59 in me. Oh no, not like that. Oh, got reset.
Are you serious? Are you dead set?
I'm gonna try and be a bit quiet because I got neighbours.
How do I get reset and then get a penalty after I get reset?
Oh my goodness. What a joke. In the wise words of Baptiste Beauvoir, oh, I got a penalty for that. That
is some BS right there.
If you get reset, you still get a penalty.
Oh my god, that's GT7, buddy, yeah. Fair enough.
Oh my god. Like, I'm not angry, it's just amusing that the game can have a reset feature, but it still will penalize you, even if you've been reset.
Another lazy day.
Oh, I got a penalty for that.
Bang. Okay. Let's refocus. I'm going to stay in this session because I want the Delta.
Thank you. 59 is the goal. 59.999 or better. I got time in this corner. And I've got time at turn two. Just multitasking, watching you and playing F1 Manager at the same time. Very good. I'm sure that's what the Ferrari pit wall will probably doing throughout this year. Just watching some Joe Blow stream because they couldn't focus on their strategy, could they? Poor Ferrari. Tell you what, this manager's silly season is pretty entertaining though, to be fair. I turned in too early there. I've got time there as well because I turned in too early. Okay, I've got time in this lap. Oh no! I'm gonna get a penalty. Yeah, that's okay. I've got the time in me, definitely. Because it was a messy first sector. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't use first there. I think some people are. But I think I'm over-rotating. I'm not good enough with it. idea. Too deep. All I hit was 101s. Ah, yeah, it's such a hard car. Such a hard time trial. Do you get along with the X2019? Yes, you do. It's so, I find it really slippery. So I was just driving that Porsche 919, and that has more grip than this does. Easy. Jumped the curb. Ramped it. Didn't want to have the next lap ruined as well. But I don't get the best run out of the straight here, it's not too bad actually. I am crashing a lot. I know I'm pushing hard, but I know what I have to do. It's just so hard because this car is so slippery. Turn one's okay. When you get up to turn three, you have to mount that curb perfectly so the car doesn't like jump in the air, and then you have to get back on the power as soon as it lands. I think I'm taking too much speed in and getting on the power too late. Once again, we'll have another go. This corner coming up. I've turned in too late there. You can see I should be on full power by now. All good, Banana Josh. No worries, mate. Edit your Nations Cup video. Very nice. Happy editing. Nations Cup. What combination is that? This car, bang. That was this car at Trial Mountain, that's right. Round two, very nice. Thanks for stopping by on the stream, Josh. I really appreciate it. Okay, let's get this 59. I know I can do it. Come on. Yes. Hands are sweating. Oh my goodness. Did you catch the end of that, Josh? Oh, wow. Let's watch it. Got a good exit out of that corner. That's what did it. It's a bit wide there. That wasn't the best. I lost 10th. And then I knew what I needed to do coming into here. That's good. Okay. The superior end. Hello, how you going? The superior end. Oh, I struggle so bad in the blind S's. Yeah. I'll just save this replay. I just don't understand these times. Like 58.6, 1.2 seconds faster than me. Right, where do I sit here? Faster than Super GT. Get a load of that. Super GT, eat your heart out. But there's so many people. Hyper absolutely smashes these time trials. He gets into it. And of course you got Mr. MCA. Boss? Oh, Foss. He was in the chat earlier. In P9. Danny. Shall we watch the top lap? Busnelli. Oh yeah. Oh, there's no replay attached to it. Okay. Valerio Gallo, P2 in the world. But yeah, those blind S's are really hard. I've got the corner markers on. But I do use those. I have them on all the time. Because I sometimes use them. But here in particular, I do. I use them at... when I'm coming down the hill. So like, you go through turn one. And you curve to the left. Jump the curb, turn right, and then left. That next right, I use the corner marker. Both of them throws me off being a controller guy. Yeah, okay. The controller can be quite difficult because it can be pretty twitchy at times. And because of the like input smoothing you get, so like you move the stick, but it like it takes a bit to respond. You can turn in early, turn out and turn back in, but all that takes too long and then you're offline. And that can be really difficult. Okay, 59.8. I'll take that. I do want to see the top time, though, because Andrew mentioned... Andrew mentioned there was grass usage, which is always interesting. Alright. So this here, this is the P2 in the world. Because P1 does not have a replay. Oh, what did the camera do there? Add on top PS4 user, won't move to a PS5 like just Devin did when he moved to Australia. Won't move. Yeah, yeah.
Well, they're still hard to come by as well. So it's so difficult. And then if you do find one, they're like heinously expensive. Yeah, the like when I budget for my month, the month that I bought mine, I was like, I had nothing, left. It was a very big expense. But I think, watch the camera here. What the heck? Yeah, the camera like does a weird jump on the curve. Oh, well. Let's see what this grass usage is then. God, I mean, it's a beautiful lap. He knew as well, he didn't keep going. Like, it's a beautiful lap, don't get me wrong, but man, is it quick. But 59.9, 1 minute point three, essentially, so what, I'm a little bit under half a second. A little bit less than half a second ahead, so that I'll take that. Okay. Hopefully that'll be 2 million in the bag. Just get these gifts, but I'm thinking I might call the stream there. So that's 11 o'clock my time. Yay, the worst prize. How good. I love getting the worst prize. But yeah, I might call the stream there, I think. Go and hit the hay, so to speak. Pretty good stream that one. We got these two races done. Which is always good. We got within the gold time for the time trial, so that I got everything done. That's really, really positive. But yeah, I should get back. Where am I up to in here? Yeah, the sun also rises. I still haven't finished these just yet. So we'll definitely have to get back on it. We've got all these endurance races too. These will be fun. But yeah, maybe that'll be the next stream. Who knows? But yeah, anyway, so yeah. Do hit the like button if you enjoyed. And make sure to subscribe as well, because I'll have some videos coming. Trackside Lounge Podcast recorded an episode today. So keep an eye out in the coming week for that as well. And make sure to subscribe to that channel. But yeah, otherwise, that'll be the end of this stream tonight. And that means that is it from me. So I'd like to thank everyone for jumping in chat, having a chat, watching, and interacting. wouldn't do it without it. So thanks very much. But yeah, that's going to finish up this stream tonight. So I'll see everyone later.